There's two types of people in this world. There's gas generator folks and there's power station folks. The problem is, I think that gas generator folks, at least some of them, haven't taken the time to fully understand where these power stations come into play, and vice versa. I don't think that a lot of power station folks have realized what an advantage it is to also still have a gas generator. Personally, I use both, and for a lot of people, I actually think that that makes a lot of sense. And this video isn't to start a fight. We're not trying to say one is better than the other. Just hear us out. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Last month we had an ice storm come through and it knocked out the power here and at our houses for about 3 whole days, and some of the surrounding areas to us had no power for as much as 10 days. Personally, I was able to keep my house powered up with an old Delta Pro, and when that thing would die because it was still kind of stormy out, I would use a generator to charge it back up. And in that entire 3-day outage, I barely used a full tank of gas on this EcoFlow generator. And for those 3 days, I was running my furnace, my hot water tank, my fridge, some lights, a TV at night, enough to be comfortable. And after the 15th person texted us and asked if we wanted to come over for heat and water, assuming we didn't have any because we didn't have a generator constantly humming in our front yard, we realized it was time to make a video to spread a little bit of awareness about using a gas generator in conjunction with some form of battery backup. Traditionally, when the power goes out, most people go outside and fire up a gas generator. A generator, though, has no battery, so it needs to be running constantly to provide power so that whenever something like your sump pump tries to come on, it has access to power. And that right there is the main thing that we want to focus on in today's video. When the generator turns off, historically, so does everything that you had running. For the sake of simplicity, we're going to use the EcoFlow dual fuel generator with the EcoFlow Delta Pro 3, but it doesn't have to be that way. Most big power stations come with some form of adapter. In this case, this plugs into the Delta Pro 3, the Delta Pro Ultra, and it has a generator twist lock on the end, so you can fast charge these bigger units with a bigger generator. And the smaller units typically don't need as much power to charge them that quickly, so you can just use the regular 110 volt plug to get them charged up. Most people see the Delta Pro 3 and their first thought is, what do I do when it dies? And the answer is one of two things. If you're lucky enough to live in a place where the sun is usually always shining, and once that storm blows through, the sun comes back out, the simple answer is you use solar. Connect some panels in, it's free, it's quiet, it's simple. If you live somewhere like us, a storm usually means that there's multiple days of clouds and kind of shitty weather to follow, so you can't always rely on the sun. So one thing you could do is to get expansion batteries so that if you normally experience 2 days or 3 days of outages, you have enough battery to just strictly rip with the batteries that you have and you don't have to worry about charging your system. The other option is you use a gas generator, but you only use it to charge up your system and it's not running all the time. I know gas generators are typically cheaper than doing the backup, but the pro to this is that you don't have to worry about the cost of running these things for multiple days on end. That's one of the biggest things everybody in my neighborhood was saying, is it's so expensive to keep this thing running. We're only running like our sump pump and our fridge. So you don't have to worry about the cost. You also don't have to worry about finding an open gas station. When this storm hit us, the closest open gas station was 30 minutes away. And I'm not even kidding, the lineup to get in was at least 4 hours. I don't even know if the guy at the end of the line would have got gas. They probably sold out of gas. It was insane. In this case, if you only use just a small amount, even if you forgot to fill up and you just have a little bit in a jerry can, you're still gonna make it through. You also just don't have to listen to this thing running non-stop during the entire outage. And when your power goes out, if it's in the middle of a storm, you don't have to worry about going out into that storm to get your power back on until it's fully passed. A bonus of a power station like the Delta Pro 3 is that you can actually take this thing camping. You can do all kinds of stuff with it all year round. It doesn't just kind of sit around waiting for the power to go out. It's a great bonus utility that comes with it. So I'm gonna try to go over like a quick example just to make it make a lot of sense for everybody, so I'm not just babbling for no reason. To break it down, the Delta Pro 3 has a 4,000 watt inverter. This is the same as having a 4,000 watt generator. It can run loads up to 4,000 watts at one time. This Delta Pro 3 also has a 4,000 watt hour battery though, which basically means if you're just trying to run your fridge and your sump pump and some lights, you can pretty much run this thing for multiple days before you're ever gonna need to even think about refilling it. So in my specific scenario during this power outage that we literally just had, I was running my fridge, which uses about 1,300 watt hours per day. We made a whole video explaining how fridges work because they don't actually use as much power as everyone thinks they do. It's in the description down below if you're trying to learn more about that. But 1,300 watt hours per day is about 54 watts per hour. My sump pump is 4 amps, so it uses about 480 watts when it's running. So it's well within our 4,000 watt inverter limit when it's actually on. And let's be really extreme with this, a lot more extreme than it was in my case. Let's say that water is just nonstop flowing into your pit it's gonna run for about 10 seconds to purge that, and then it's gonna start filling back up. And let's say it does that cycle every 3 minutes. If it runs every 3 minutes for 10 seconds at a time, it'll run about 3.3 minutes per hour. The 480 watts is about 8 watts per minute of it running. So it's gonna use about 26.4 watts per hour if that's just going ham. So over the course of 24 hours, it's gonna use 633 watt hours out of your battery bank. My furnace is about 450 watts when it's running. It's just a gas furnace. It's just a fan that's taking power. And in my experience, it was about 0 degrees and it would come on for about 10 minutes every hour. Call it 15 minutes. That's about 112.5 watt hours per hour. That adds up to about 2,700 watt hours per day. So keeping your sump pump running, your fridge on, and your furnace going, in this example, it's gonna cost you about 4,633 watt hours per day. So your 4,000 watt hour battery on your Delta Pro 3 would almost last you 24 hours, more like 22 or 23. And so now if solar isn't an option, a generator is a great way to charge this thing up that once pretty much every day. So in my case, what we actually did was we would wake up in the morning and we would plug it in and we'd run the generator for about 30 minutes to bring the Delta Pro back up to 100%. Turn off the generator, it's off all day. We're living life like it's normal, it's quiet, we got some lights on, the furnace going, everything's good. No noise, no wasted gas, and my neighbors think that I'm cold and dead in my basement. And then near the end of the day, we plug that thing back into the generator, run it for another about half an hour. We actually kind of watched a couple movies, ran the TV, ran it a little bit more, okay? But you can run it for about a half an hour, charge it back up again, get it back up to 100%. We don't ever wanna kind of see it go low, and then we go to bed. So in total, we're running just over an hour of generator per day, but we have nonstop power all day and everything's running and it's quiet, it's efficient, and it's nice. The point here is that this is a very easy way to have clean and quiet power inside of your house. Like I keep the Delta Pro in the house, and if we're trying to do something, you can wheel it into another room, run extension cables, do whatever you gotta do. You only have to go outside into the storm to just run the generator really quickly for that half an hour period. And this applies to not just portable power stations, but traditional solar kits too. A lot of people think that you need a full solar kit to go solar, but a lot of people take advantage of these kits without panels at all. And what they do is they just have the batteries charging, and when the power goes out, the inverter kicks on, uses the batteries to power the house, and same thing goes here. You can use a generator to charge your traditional server rack batteries, your inverter can run your house, and everything works nicely that way. And the bonus to a system like that is that you can actually peak shave with it. So on the rest of the year, the Delta Pro 3 is great for taking it camping and it's portable. This system is great for charging the batteries in the nighttime when your rate is really low, and then dispersing them during the daytime when your rate is really high. And it'll probably pay itself off if you do that within like a couple years, depending on how much you spend on your system. It's a great way to kind of repay the system and also, again, just have that battery backup ready for whenever a storm comes. In my experience, it just seems like everyone is kind of for gas, but then when this outage happened, I'm walking around with my dog, everybody's generators are just ripping. They're not even home. Nothing's even running. It's just running in case the sump pump needs to come on or to keep the fridge on. They're burning through gas and then complaining about how they can't get gas, the price of gas. I barely used a little 10 liter jerry can. I think I filled this thing one time. And sure, it's a little bit more expensive to do it this way. The point is, it's just like adopting the battery backup system, whether that's literal just batteries, power station, an inverter, whatever way you want to go. It's just a nicer experience, you know? It's a better experience when the power's out, especially if you live somewhere where this happens a lot. And so if you guys are looking at doing something like this, we have tons of product reviews on the channel. We've reviewed all kinds of power stations. We have kind of informative videos to try to educate you on what to pick depending on what your needs are, like how to do the math for systems your size, all that kind of stuff. If you want to just rip a gas generator, then rip a gas generator. There's really no harm. It's cheaper upfront to do it. It's just like, if you can afford to get both, it's just a way better user experience. We will make sure to just riddle the description with discount codes for all the power stations that we recommend, because I know that storm season is kind of coming. I know a lot of you guys might be kind of in the market to get something for this year. If you want a free power station, we have information for this month's giveaway in the description down below. Otherwise, that is all we got for you. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.